So my goal for this video is to help you understand how to solve this question from the 2023 A-level further math paper. So this test question has three parts, and the main thing is that we need to know how to solve this integral. But the good thing is that for part A, they give us the biggest hint, and that is we have to complete the square of this quadratic. So let's write that down right here. And then I will have to minus the 5 right here, and then leave a space here. To complete the square, first we make sure we have a 1 in front of the x squared, which we do. And then look at the coefficient of x, which is 4. Now, go ahead and take half of 4, and then square that. So this is the little formula that you have to remember. Right here, this is 2 squared, which is 4. And this is the number that we will have to add right here. And then go ahead, minus the same number at the very end. This way, the first three terms is just going to give us a perfect square, x plus 2 squared, and then minus 5 minus 4 is of course minus 9. And then we are done for the first part. Okay, it's quite nice that they give us this. Now, part B, we just have to solve this integral. So we look at this as the integral of 1 over square root, and then we will have x plus 2 squared minus, for the 9, we have to look at this as 3 squared, and you will see why dx. Now, to integrate this, well, the test direction says we can just use the standard result, so we will use the standard result. So here's a note for you guys. Note, if we have the integral of 1 over square root, let's say we have some u squared minus some number a squared, then we are integrating this in the u world. Then either you can use ln absolute value of u plus square root of u squared minus a squared, and then plus c. This is the standard result I have on this board. And then the other one is you can also use the inverse hyperbolic cosine. So I can write it down like this. Inverse hyperbolic cosine. And then you will just have u over a plus c. Of course, this right here is easier, but maybe we are not familiar with this too much. Here's the thing though. Either way is okay for part B, but for part C, our final answer should be in terms of ln. So I'm just going to stick with this right here, because for part C purpose. That said though, we will just have the following. Notice, here's our u. U is x squared plus 2. And then if you differentiate that, du is the same as dx. So we don't have to multiply or divide anything. And then the 3 right here is our a. So this right here is just going to be ln absolute value. The u is dx plus 2. And then we add the square root. And then u squared, which is again x plus 2, square that, and then minus a squared, which is 3 squared, like this, and then close that, and then put a plus c. This is okay. Well, if you want to multiply this out, which is just this, which is just that, I think that's fine too. Either way though, I'm going to leave it like this. And don't forget the plus c. I don't know if they take away points for missing the plus c or not, but just remember to put it down, that's the best. Now for part C, we will have to find the mean value of this function between 3 and 13. And this right here is just the same as the average value, right? So we have to integrate it. It's just kind of like the super version of addition. You have to add up everything. And then divide it by the length of this interval. It's just like divided by how many items there are. So I'm just going to write this down. So the mean value is going to be, first, let's just go ahead and put down 1 over 13 minus 3, because that's the length of this interval, and then we will have to integrate from 3 to 13 of this function, 1 over square root of x squared plus 4x minus 5. Okay, so here we have 1 over 10. The result of this integration is right there, so I'm just going to write that down. Ln absolute value x plus 2 plus the square root, still x plus 2 squared minus 3 squared. And then we have to plug in numbers 3 to 13. So plug in 13 and then plug in 3 into the x. And in fact, we do not need to use the absolute value because we are just going from positive 3 to positive 13, right? So if you don't want to use the absolute value here, you can quickly erase them and then change them to parentheses. Okay, and then finally, we just have to compute this. So I'm going to continue right here. For first, we have 1 over 10 ln, and then this right here is 15 plus. Okay, so this right here is 15 squared, which is 225, and then minus 9, so we have 216. So that's plus square root of 216. And I'm going to simplify this later. And then we have minus 1 over 10 ln, and then this is 5 plus. Okay, so this right here is 5 squared, and that's 25 minus 9, which is 16. So square root of 16. So, because the answer wants us to write it in terms of a times ln b form, so I'm going to just combine them a little bit. I'm going to first factor out the 1 over 10, and then we have ln, and then 15 plus square root of 216, because 16 is divisible by 4, right? The last two digits divisible by 4, so I can use 4. So, square root of 4 times square root of 54. Furthermore, this right here is 9 times 6, so this right here is square root of 9 times square root of 6. So this right here gives us 2, this right here gives us 3. So 2 times 3, we have 6, and then square root of 6. Okay, and then I'm factoring out the 1 over 10, right? So that, and here will be a minus, and then we have ln. And then this is just 5 plus, of course, this is just 4. So 5 plus 4 is just 9. So it's like that. And then we can just do this minus that. So this divided by that in 1 ln. So 1 over 10 ln of 15 plus 6 square root of 6 over 9. Now, simplify this a little bit. On the top, I'm going to factor out as 3. So we have 5 plus 2 square root of 6, reduce that out. So final answer, 1 over 10 ln of 5 plus 2 square root of 6 over 3. Just like this. That's it.